The best time to test for typhoid is the early days of infection, usually before the first symptom. The highest levels of bacteria that can be seen in the blood during testing are likely present before symptoms develop. Consider Mr. John, who drank a contaminated water 1 week ago, now walked into a hospital to complain of stomach pain and fever. If he is having typhoid, taking his blood sample for culture at this time will not give a positive result for typhoid bacterial. Note, blood culture simply means to grow typhoid bacterials from someone's blood. This means that by the time the patient is coming to hospital with a complaint, the blood samples taken at this time will not give a positive result because the bacterial is no longer in the blood at that time. This leads to frequent misdiagnosis. In this video, we will explain how to solve this problem. Accurate diagnosis of typhoid is critical to ensuring that those who are sick receive timely medical attention and appropriate treatment. Current typhoid diagnosis has many challenges due to both the nature of the disease as well as the difficulties with available diagnostic tools. Typhoid symptoms are similar to many other diseases, including malaria, pneumonia, influenza, and other febrile illnesses. This leads to frequent misdiagnosis, and it demonstrates the need for more accurate and rapid diagnostic tests. Current typhoid diagnostics. According to the World Health Organization, a definitive diagnosis of typhoid requires isolation of the Salmonella typhi bacterium through either blood, urine, stool, or bone marrow culture. Usually, multiple poo samples taken at intervals increase the chance of finding the bacterial in the sample. This method is considered the gold standard for typhoid diagnosis, though it still has serious practical limitations. In reality and in practice, only 40 to 60% of typhoid cases are correctly identified due to the low levels of bacteria in the blood during illness. The best time to test is the early days of infection, usually during incubation period. The highest levels of bacteria that can be seen in the blood during testing are likely present before clinical symptoms develop. This means that by the time the patient is coming to hospital with a complaint, the blood samples taken at this time will not give a positive result because the bacterial is no longer in the blood at that time. The patient's prior use of antibiotics as well as the volume of blood collected for the sample also affect the accuracy of blood culture test. Furthermore, results are not available until several days after the blood is taken, limiting the test's usefulness in a clinical setting where a healthcare worker must make a decision about treatment quickly. Other challenges associated with typhoid test are 1. Blood cultures are expensive and require specialized personnel and laboratory facilities to perform. 2. Blood culture facilities are rare in many low-resource countries and are often limited to major hospitals and large cities. What is the way forward? The development of a more cost-effective, rapid diagnostic test is needed to help avoid this diagnostics dilemma. Because of these limitations, the diagnosis of typhoid in most low-resource settings is made based on clinical criteria, which is challenging due to the nonspecificity of typhoid symptoms. Because typhoid symptoms are common to many other illnesses such as malaria and dengue, gastroenteritis, patients are frequently misdiagnosed. Difficulties with accurate typhoid diagnostics and appropriate treatment can lead to more serious complications and can contribute to drug resistance. Additional methods include urine or stool culture, which, while easier and cheaper to perform, do not have reliable accuracy. The Widal test, developed in the late 18th century, now over 200 years ago, is simple and inexpensive, but useless because but is not sensitive and not specific and should not be used for diagnosis as it is frequently inaccurate. The Widal test involves testing for agglutinating antibody levels in the patient's blood. In conclusion, 1. Let your doctor decide whether to do a test for you or not. 2. Your doctor does not need a test before they start treating you for typhoid. 3. The most popular typhoid test called Widal test is no longer relevant in treatment of typhoid. 4. If your test results suggest that a different antibiotics should be used, your doctor can change your antibiotics to the one recommended by the test. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to our channel to know when we post an update on this. You are watching Zoom Hospital Channel and listening to Work of Dr. Criorti. Thanks for watching.